Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Today my presentation title is Important Battles in Indian History. So let's proceed to the presentation. The first battle of Panipat on 21st April 1526 was fought between the invading forces of Babur and the Lodi dynasty. It took place in North India and marked the beginnings of the Mughal Empire and the end of Delhi Sultanate. The result, Delhi Sultanate was annexed by the Mughals. The second battle of Panipat, it was fought on 5th November 1556 between the Hindu Emperor of North India, Hemchandra Vikramaditya, and forces of Akbar, and the result, Mughal Empire victory. The third battle of Panipat took place on 14th January 1761 at Panipat, about 97 km north of Delhi, between the Maratha Empire and the invading Afghan army of the King of Afghans, Ahmad Shah Abdali, supported by three Indian allies, and the result, Ahmad Shah victory. The Battle of Khanwa, it was fought near the village of Khanwa in Bharatpur district of Rajasthan on March 16, 1527. It was fought between the invading forces of the first Mughal Emperor Babur and the Rajput forces led by Rana Sanga of Mewar after the Battle of Panipat. And the result, decisive victory of the first Mughal Emperor Babur and the consolidation of Mughal power in India. The Battle of Plassey was a decisive victory of British East India Company over the Nawab of Bengal and his French allies on 23rd June 1757. Under the leadership of Robert Clive, which was possible due to the defection of Mir Jafar Ali Khan, who was Siraju Daula's commander-in-chief, and the result, British victory. The Battle of Haldighati, it was a battle fought on 18th June 1576 between cavalry and archers supporting the Rana of Mewar, Marana Pratap, and the Mughal Emperor Akbar's force, led by Man Singh I of Ambar, and the result, Mughal victory. The Battle of Buxar, it was fought on 22nd October 1764 between the forces under the command of British East India Company led by Hector Munro and the combined armies of Mir Qasim, the Nawab of Bengal till 1763. Mir Jafar was made the Nawab of Bengal for a second time in 1763 by the company just after the battle, and the result, English East India Company victory. Now the Battle of Ghagra. It was fought on 6th May 1529. It was a major battle for the conquest of India by the Mughal Empire. It followed the first battle of Panipat in 1526 and the battle of Khanwa in 1527, and the result, decisive Mughal victory. The first battle of Tarain was fought in 1191 between the Ghurids against the Chahmanas and their allies near Tarain. The Chahmanas King Prithviraj Chauhan defeated the Ghurids King Mulizuddin, who avenged his defeat at the Second Battle of Tarain a year later, and the result, Chahmanas victory, Ghurid invasion of India repulsed. The Second Battle of Tarain, it was fought in 1192 by the Ghurids against the Chahmanas and their allies near Tarain. The Ghurid King Mulizuddin defeated the Chahmanas King Prithviraj Chauhan, thus avenging his earlier defeat at the First Battle of Tarain. It the result of the battle, Ghurid's victory. The Third Battle of Tarain, it was fought in 1215 between Shamsuddin Iltutmish and Yeldoj near Tarain, and the result, Shamsuddin Iltutmish victory. Now the Battle of Chausa, it was a notable military engagement between the Mughal Emperor Humayun and the Afghan Sher Shah Suri. It was fought on 26 June 1539 at Chausa, 10 miles southwest of Buxar in modern-day Bihar, India. Humayun escaped from the battlefield to save his life, and the result of battle, Sher Shah Suri victory. The Battle of Talikota was a watershed battle fought between the Vijayanagara Empire and an alliance of the Deccan Sultanate, who united in order to defeat Aliya Ramraya. The battle took place at Talikoti, today a town in northern Karnataka, about 80 kilometers to the southeast from the city of Bijapur, and the result, decisive victory of Deccan Sultanate alliance, sacking of Vijayanagara, decline of the Vijayanagara Empire. The Kalinga War, it was fought in 261 BC in what is now India between the Maurya Empire under Ashoka and the state of Kalinga. Raja Anant Padmanabhan an independent feudal kingdom located on the east coast in the present day state of Odisha and north parts of Andhra Pradesh, and the result of Kalinga War, Maurya Compromise settlement. The Battle of Chamkaur. It was fought on 6 December 1704 and also known as Battle of Chamkaur Sahib. It was a battle fought between the Khalsa, led by Guru Gobind Singh, and the coalition forces of the Mughals, led by Wazir Khan. Guru Gobind Singh makes a reference to this battle in his victory letter, Zafarnama, and the result of battle, Mughal victory. The Battle of Karnal. It was fought on 24th February 1739. It was a decisive victory of Nadir Shah, the founder of the Afsari's dynasty of Persia, during his invasion of India. Nadir's forces defeated the army of Muhammad Shah within 3 hours, despite being heavily outnumbered, paving the way for the Persian sack of Delhi. And the result of battle, decisive Persian victory. Battle of Vandivas. It was fought on January 2, 1760. In the history of India, a confrontation between the French under the Comte de Lally and the British under Sir Iriacute. It was the decisive battle in the Anglo-French struggle in southern India, Vandevasi, Tamil Nadu, during the Seven Years' War, 1756 to 1763, and the result, decisive British victory. The Battle of Chandavar. It was fought in 1193 to 1194. It was fought between Muhammad Ghori and Jai Chand of Kanauj of the Gadwala dynasty. It took place at Chandavar, modern Chandawal, near Firozabad, on the Yamuna River close to Agra. Jai Chand was defeated, giving Muhammad control of much of northern India. In the result, Ghurid victory. Then Battle of Samugad. It was fought in 29th May 1658. Jange Samugad was a decisive battle in the struggle for the throne during the Mughal War of Succession between the sons of the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan, between Aurangzeb and Imperial forces led by Dara Shikoh after the Emperor's serious illness in September 1657, and the result, decisive victory and coronation of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb. The Battle of Saragadi. It was fought between the Tira Campaign on 12 September 1897 between the British Raj and Afghan tribesmen. On 12 September 1897, estimated 12,000 to 24,000 Orakchai and Afridi tribesmen were seen near Gogra at Samnasuk and round Saragadi, cutting off Fort Gulistan from Fort Lockhart. In 1897, a small outpost called Saragadi, 40 miles away from the British garrison town of Kohat, in what is now in Pakistan, 21 Sikh soldiers stood their ground against an onslaught of 10,000 enemy tribesmen. Their gallantry in fighting to the bitter end cemented their reputation as brave and devoted to their duty, and the soldiers were recognized by the British with memorials, a battle honor, and a regimental holiday. And the results, Afghan victory. The Battle of the Hydaspes. It was fought in 326 BC between Alexander the Great and King Porus of the Paro Kingdom on the banks of the Jhelum River in the Punjab region of the Indian subcontinent. The battle resulted in a Greek victory and the surrender of Porus. The result of the battle, Macedonian victory, annexation of Punjab, Porus appointed plenipotentiary satrap of the new provinces. The First Anglo-Mysore War. It was between 1766 to 1769. It was a conflict in India between the Sultanate of Mysore and the East India Company. The war was instigated in part by machinations of Asaf Jah II, the Nizam of Hyderabad, who sought to divert the company resources from attempts to gain control of the northern Sircars, and the result, Mysore victory. The siege of Chittorgarh was a part of campaign of the Mughal Empire against the Kingdom of Mewar in 23rd October 1567 to 23rd February 1568. The forces led by Akbar surrounded and besieged 8,000 Rajputs and around 40,000 peasants under the command of Jamal in Chittorgarh, and the result was Mughal victory. The Battle of Tukaroi, also known as the Battle of Bajhora or the Battle of Mughalmari was fought between the Mughal Empire and the Bengal Sultanate on 3rd March 1575 near the village of Tukaroi in present-day Balasore district of Odisha. It resulted in a Mughal victory and greatly weakened the Bengal Sultanate, and the result decisive Mughal victory. The siege of Golconda. It occurred in January 1687 when Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb led his forces to besiege the Qutub Shahi dynasty at Golconda Fort and was home to the Kolur mine. The ruler of Golconda was the well-entrenched Abul Hasan Qutub Shah, and the result, victory of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb and the overthrow and imprisonment of Abul Hasan Qutub Shah. The Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb was also handed over famous diamonds and gained full control of the Kolur mine. Nader Shah invasion of India. Emperor Nader Shah, the Shah of Persia and the founder of the Afsarid dynasty of Persia, invaded northern India, eventually attacking Delhi in March 1739. His army had easily defeated the Mughals at the battle at Karnal and would eventually capture the Mughal capital in the aftermath of the battle. And the result, decisive Persian victory, Delhi sacked and looted, decline of the Mughal Empire. The Battle of Rajmahal. It was fought on 12th July 1576, which was a battle that took place between the Mughal Empire and the Karani dynasty that ruled the Sultanate of Bengal in 16th century. The battle resulted in a decisive victory for the Mughals, and the result, decisive Mughal victory. Battle of Pawankhind. It was fought on 13th July 1660. It was a rear guard last stand that took place on 13th July 1660 at a mountain pass in the vicinity of Fort Vishalgarh near the city of Kolhapur, Maharashtra, India, between the Maratha warrior Baji Prabhu Deshpande and Siddhi Masood of Adil Shah Sultanate. In the result, tactical Bijapur victory, a strategic Maratha victory. The Battle of Pratapgarh. It was a land battle fought on 10th November 1659 at the fort of Pratapgarh near the town of Satara, Maharashtra, between the forces of the Maratha king Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and the Adil Shahi general Afzal Khan. The Marathas defeated and Adil Shahi forces despite being outnumbered. Result, decisive Maratha victory and major territorial gain for the Maratha forces. The Battle of Imphal. It took place in a region around the city of Imphal, the capital of the state of Manipur in northeast India, from March 1944 until July 1944. Japanese armies attempted to destroy the Allied forces at Imphal and invade India, but were driven back into Burma with heavy losses. The result, British victory. The Battle of Chanderi. It took place in January 1528 in the aftermath of the Battle of Khanwa, in which the Mughal Emperor Babur had defeated a confederacy of Rajputs and Afghans, which was headed by Rana Sanga of Mewar. The Battle of Arni. It took place at Arni, India, on 3rd December 1751 during the Second Carnatic War. A British-led force under the command of Robert Clive defeated and routed a much larger Franco-Indian force under the command of Raja Sahib. The French troops were guarding a convoy of treasure, and the result, decisive British victory. The Battle of Madras. It is also known as Fall of Madras, took place in September 1746 during the War of the Austrian Succession, when a French force attacked and captured the city of Madras from its British garrison. Result, French victory. The Battle of Golden Rock. It was fought between forces of the British and French East India Companies on 26 June 1753 during the Second Carnatic War. French troops, assisted by Mysorean troops led by Hyder Ali, assaulted a British outpost near Trichrapalli, drawing the main British force defending, and the result, British victory. The Battle of Tughlakabad. It was a notable battle fought on 7th October 1556 between Hemchandra Vikramaditya, also known as Hemu, was the general of Adil Shah Suri, and the forces of the Mughal Emperor Akbar led by Taradi Beg Khan at Tughlakabad near Delhi, and the result, victory of the Suri Empire. the Battle of Chingalpet. It was a short siege in early 1752 during the Second Carnatic War. About 700 British East India Company recruits and sepoys under the command of Robert Clive captured the fortress of Chingalpet near Madras. Defended by French East India Company garrison of about 40 European and 500 troops, and the result, British Arcot victory. The Battle of Aliwal, it was fought on 28 January 1846 between British and Sikh forces in northern India, now Punjab. The British were led by Sir Harry Smith, while the Sikhs were led by Ranjot Singh Majithia. Britain's victory in the battle is sometimes regarded as the turning point in the First Anglo-Sikh War. Result was British victory. The Battle of Ambur. It was fought on 3rd August 1749. It was the first major battle of the Second Carnatic War. The battle was initiated by Muzaffar Jung and supported by Joseph Francois Dupleix and led by Chanda Sahib, who sought to overthrow Anwaruddin Muhammad Khan, the Nawab of the Carnatic, for the supporting Nasir Jung's claim to be Nizam of Hyderabad, and the result, decisive Allied victory. The Battle of Kannauj, it was fought between Sher Shah Suri and Humayun. Humayun was defeated. Humayun became a fugitive and Sher Khan became the master of Agra and Delhi. The battle was fought on 17th May 1540. The Battle of Khatoli, it was fought in 1518 between the Lodi dynasty under Ibrahim Lodi and the Kingdom of Mewar under Rana Sanga, during which the latter emerged victorious. The result, decisive Rajput victory. Battle of Dholpur, battle between Ibrahim Lodi and Rana Sanga in 1549. Ibrahim Lodi was smarting under his defeat at Battle of Khatoli. To avenge it, he made great preparation and moved against Rana Sanga, and the result, Rajput victory. Siege of Ranthambore. On February 8, 1568, Akbar led a massive Mughal army composed of over 50,000 men and besieged Ranthambore fort. Akbar had become emboldened after his victories at the Battle of Thanesar and the siege of Chittorgarh, and only Ranthambore fort remained unconquered. And the result, a successful siege by Mughal Emperor Akbar causes the Rajput leader Rai Surjanhada to surrender Ranthambore fort. Battle of Patan, it was fought on 20th June 1790 between the Kingdom of Gwalior and the alliance formed by the Kingdom of Jaipur, which resulted in a decisive Maratha victory. Then Battle of Gagron. The first battle between the Rana Sanga was the Battle of Gagron in 1519 with Sultan Muhammad of Malwa. Sultan Mahmud was trounced and taken prisoner in the war. Rana Sanga extended traditional chivalry and benevolence to him. Sultan Muhammad was treated like a guest, and his kingdom was restored to him by the Rana. So this presentation was all about the important battles in Indian history. Now my presentation ends here. I have given here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it, and provide your kind and valuable feedback. Thank you.